In this video, I'll show how to use the TI-84 graphing calculator to find the value of a derivative at a given value of x, and we'll take a look at two examples. We want to find the value of the derivative of f of x when x equals 2, and here's our given function. So again, our goal is to find the value of the derivative function when x equals 2. The TI-84 calculator is not going to give us the derivative function, but it will give us the value of the derivative at a given value of x. And there are two ways of doing this. One way is from the home screen. So if we press the math button, and we want to scroll down to option 8, or press 8, we're looking for this command here, and derive. I'm going to press enter, and then we type in the right side of our function. So we have x to the third minus 5x squared plus 2. Now we have to press comma x and then comma the value of x that we want to evaluate the derivative at, which is 2. Close parenthesis and press enter. A common error is to forget to put this comma x in the command. The next thing is, notice how it's giving us negative 7.999 and so on. The calculator is not perfect. We need to recognize this as negative 8. So let's go ahead and write this down, and then I'll show you a second way to find the same value. Remember, this would be the slope of the tangent line when x is equal to positive 2, which we'll show in just a moment. The second way to do this is from the graph screen. So first we'll press y equals. Notice how I've already entered the function in here. So now I'm going to press graph. Here's the graph of our function. So from this screen, we can also just press second trace for the calculation menu, and then select option 6 for dy dx. Once we select option 6, we need to type in the x value of 2. So we press 2, enter, and notice how the derivative is equal to the same value that was on the home screen, which we need to recognize as negative 8. Of course, we could verify this by hand. F prime of x, using the power rule, would just be 3x squared minus 10x, and then plus 0, then we could just sub in 2. So we'd have 3 times 2 squared minus 10 times 2. Well, this would be 4 times 3, that's 12, minus 20, which is equal to negative 8. And again, what this value tells us is, going back to the graph of our function, at x equals positive 2, or at this point here, the slope of the tangent line would be negative 8. Let's take a look at a second example. We want to find the value of the derivative of our function at the point negative 1, 1 half. Again, here they're giving us the point, but to do this, we actually only need the value of x equals negative 1. So let's go back to our calculator, and we'll show it both ways again. So from the home screen, we're going to press math option 8, enter, type in our function. We need to be careful here. We want parentheses around the numerator and denominator. So we have an open parenthesis, x minus 1, close parenthesis divided by open parenthesis, x minus 3, comma x, comma, the x value is negative 1. Close parenthesis, press enter. Again, the calculator is not perfect. We need to recognize this as x equals negative 0.125. So f prime of negative 1 is equal to negative 0.125 or 0.125. We may want this in fraction form. So if we go back to the calculator, it won't convert this to a fraction for us, but if we type in negative 0.125 and then press math enter enter, it's equal to negative 1/8, which hopefully we do recognize. And let's also show this again using the graph screen. So we'll press y equals, clear out the old function, type in the new function. Again, these parentheses are required. press graph. And then from here, we press second trace for calculation, and then option 6. And then we type in the x value, which is negative 1. And again, notice how it's giving us negative 0.125, which is equal to negative 1/8. If we did want to verify this one by hand, we'd have to use the quotient rule given here below. Let's go and just take a moment and do that. Notice our denominator is a denominator squared. The numerator is going to be the denominator, x minus 3, times the derivative of the numerator, which is just 1, minus the numerator, times the derivative of the denominator, which is just 1. Let's go ahead and simplify this. So here we have x minus 3. This would be minus x plus 1, so that simplifies to negative 2. So then we sub in negative 1 for x. We'd have negative 2 all over negative 1 minus 3 squared. This ends up being negative 2 over 16, which is negative 1/8. And again, graphically, what this is telling us is, at this point here on our function, the tangent line would have a slope of negative 1/8. Let's go ahead and verify that. Here's the point we're referring to. This red tangent line does have a slope of negative 1/8. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.